Hello everybody and welcome back to Let's Play Odin Sphere, Leifdrasir. In the last episode, we came down into the pits of hell once again. Well, oh, this isn't really hell, this is more, what is this, the Vulcan lava pits? Interesting enough. Anyway, we came to steal a sacred flame so that we could actually craft something strong enough to actually destroy Odin's cipher. So in this episode, we're going to continue on. I'm assuming that the key to this door will be later on and not in this small area that I missed. Apparently, it's probably useless, the chest that I missed in that area. I don't think it has anything of vital importance in it. But overall, I think we'll be fine. We'll just keep getting juggled. Oh, come on. I'm still very bad with Mercedes, but I have gotten a couple smaller things with her. So, I got the upgrade where it makes it her do more damage on the ground. So, when I'm shooting on the ground, it should be a lot easier for me. Not only that, I also made it I also got the upgrade that allows her to have 30% more defense in the air, meaning that whenever I'm flying around trying to avoid attacks, even when I take the occasional one, I should have a little bit of an easier time. Now, I'm assuming this is double chicken. Or not. Huh, I wasn't expecting the Children of Fire. Alright, well, it should be fine overall. Well, at least, as long as I'm in the air, at least I'm not taking massive amounts of damage. Let's just see. There we go. Yeah, as long as I'm flying, it's a little bit easier, but let's see. If you're in a boss fight, I highly recommend, because it's something that I just learned about recently, unlimited ammo, incredibly useful. It's basically one of her super skills when you think about it, but the big advantage of it is that you can literally keep firing forever as long as it lasts, and it will last a long time if you fully upgrade it. So you'll notice that I'm doing quite a bit of massive damage, though it did run out, or it still ran out relatively quickly. So a good way to maximize its effectiveness is to use it right when it's about to run out. Like, right when your pal meter is about to run out. Because then you can just kind of wait for it to come back. And if you get kills, it still counts towards restoring your pal meter. So, it's pretty good for those big groups as well. Considering Mercedes' her pal meter and her PP come back incredibly quickly. Though, overall, this doesn't seem like it's that big of a challenge all of a sudden. Though that might just be because of the fact that these guys can fly, meaning it's a little bit easier for me to hit them while flying. Come on. There we go. Yeah, these guys aren't so bad. But like I said before, unlimited ammo makes this a little bit easier. So, you're probably gonna see me using it a lot now. I didn't realize how important it was to Mercedes. And then I was, I actually wanted to watch a couple, like, small Mercedes-style videos to make sure I'm not gonna get completely wrecked later on in the game. And, yeah, I see a lot of people, like, using unlimited ammo mixed with the two different adds that you can kind of add to yourself, making it a little bit easier overall. Also, there's a lot of tech with dodging that I don't know and I can never fully understood. But, holy crap, she's got stuff, man. I can't believe I never figured half of that out. To be fair, though, I never claimed to be good with Mercedes. I don't know. Like I said, shmup-type characters really just don't feel good. They don't feel as good as other characters for me. I like that, the big draw for me in this game was the action-style combat. So seeing, like, this shooter-style combat kind of got a little bit weird. Not that I don't appreciate the game for what it is. It's a great game. And I like its variety in combat and overall in its presentation, I guess you could say. Okay. Maybe the Fozon crystals in this area, considering it's just an empty blank space. There's a bunch of elements here. Is that it? There's just nothing else? Guess not. Maybe up. No, dang. I don't know. I guess I was expecting something in there, but there just really wasn't. Alright. Go back to the rest area, and I guess we can just fly across really quick. No big deal. And if we go straight... Let's go for that vampire ring. As you guys probably have seen already, I really love that ring. It's pretty awesome. Ah, an upward movement. Okay. So up goes to the boss, down goes where? Here? No, nothing else down there. So let's keep going this way. Uh-oh. Yeah, now that I do like a slight bit more damage, ensuring that I can kill like smaller enemies a lot faster, my pow meter is basically unlimited. Well, not entirely, but I kill them quicker than my pow meter depletes, meaning I can just keep on going like this for a little while. But also, if I get into a pinch, I can just do that. Or just a neutral one that costs nothing. Like, it's pretty great. Ooh, an apple. Nice. I just saw it at my feet there for a second. I was like, oh, sweet. Free food. Man, that's such a weird concept, though, for... Like, when you try and relate video games to real life, I always think about, like... finding food in dungeons. Speaking of food, I should probably eat some of it. But, like, I find it so weird that in a lot of games, especially in, like... Let's talk a little bit about Castlevania, because I like Castlevania. I like how in Castlevania, there's literally wall chicken. But, like, how long has that wall chicken been there? Is it, like... Is it just, like, a rotting mount of meat that's just in the wall forever? Alright, Vampiric Ring times 2, and I have the Adversity Ring, which... This is probably making my life a living nightmare, but I don't really care. I have an ability already that allows me to get more health from any healing effect. So, it increases the ring's healing effect by a massive amount. And I don't know where in the world that... Oh my god. This is gonna be the... Okay, so this is gonna be the first time where I don't know where the heck the item is. So let's go back. Let's see. Maybe it's in one of these areas. I guess in worst case scenario, I have to search a little bit harder than usual. But it shouldn't be too bad. If it gets to the point where it's like above 10 minutes of me searching, I'll cut it. And you'll know. You guys will know where the cut will be. And also, I might end up being a bit more silent for the search. But I don't know. We'll see. Man, I'm an indecisive human being now that I think about it. Man, I really hope the thing I'm working on comes out sometime soon. Because, was there somebody guarding this chest? Because the whole thing is that the hint was, where is the salamander salamander's guarding a chest or something like that, so... It has to be somewhere close by, but it's probably not going to be... Oh god, if that's the case... Wait, did I get that sacred flame? No, I didn't. Which means it totally... Okay. That means it totally was here. And this is gonna be where the thing is. Meaning I have to start the entire thing over again. If that's the case, maybe I'll just leave now. Let's see if I can do that now. And try and make my way to it incredibly quickly. And I can just teleport to the area before the boss. So... I guess this is the first time showing this off specifically, but if you'd like, you can always go back to like the overworld and go back into the original level you're in, and it actually resets everything about it, including bosses. So if you wanted to like get better scores or anything, you can always just come back and do them again. You don't necessarily need to, like, even now, like, if you feel like you're in an area where you can just do it quickly, you can just go right ahead. But let's see. If that's the case, that means I'm probably going to be fighting that boss again. Oof. Yeah, I don't really care. These elemental guys, they don't really hurt that bad. They don't really matter. And I can go through these battle stages incredibly quickly. All the things I do to show off the things in the game I don't actually know everything about. Man, I need to find a way to dull the sound of my keyboard for later. Oh, I'm thinking too far ahead. Oh, I'm sorry, ladies and gentlemen. I didn't intend to talk about future events just yet. I do plan on doing something on my PC very, very, very soon. But my big concern is that... Oh, here we go. just never stop firing, I guess. Oop. And every hit heals me now, so that's pretty useful. Okay, come on. No. This chest? Yeah, see? I knew it. That chest held the blue flame, which is the only... Dang it, the one thing I needed just to continue. It's fine, though. Either way, I knew I would need something. Alright, so... Juggle her for a little bit. Makes it a little easier overall. God, this section is so much fun. Like, I think, honestly, so far in the game, this has to probably be my favorite part. It's so unnecessary, but it works so well. And now that I do just slightly enough damage that she can't really get many, like, significant hits off on me, it really, really works to my advantage. I say as I get hit quite hard. But really, look at that. She's already dead, and I barely did anything. God, what a good level, like, honestly. I don't need any more Napple Seeds, but it's good to know that I got the thing I needed. Alright, let's speed up the process a little bit. Oh, I probably actually could have just... I probably could have just gone automatically, but I don't think it really matters at this point. Getting some more pure cocoa doesn't really hurt. I just figured it was close enough, but... And here we go. Open the doors! Open the game! Man, I should play some JoJo All-Star Battle with John, maybe. That'd probably be a good time. Now, what is this? Critical heal, huh? That's not bad. Especially considering the fact that I crit a lot with Mercedes due to how many hits she actually can deal out. And the fact that she has unlimited ammunition, just combined, makes this an incredibly useful ability. Easily maxed, too. Amount healed up. Alright, so... Earth War, we're gonna be on the Storming Battlefield soon. I believe the Storming Battlefields are our last area. Yeah, because there's three. Meaning we've only got like a couple episodes left, with Mercedes at least. I might take a break after I finish Mercedes' chapter, just so I can prepare that thing I was talking about a little earlier. And then once I'm done with that, I'll start in the whoever the next section is. I think Velvet's the last person, but I'm not entirely sure, so I'll have to ask Adam to make a bunch of new thumbnails, and that's gonna take a long time. Speaking of which, Adam, if you're watching, thanks, man. I appreciate everything. Though I have been talking with a new artist, and she's fantastic. She's the girlfriend of a friend of mine, and she's probably one of the best artists I know. I'll advertise her more in episodes where I actually use her art, because, let's be honest, my art is terrible. I used to draw a lot when I was a kid, but I've never had good taste. I guess you could say taste in art, but it doesn't really matter. Anyway, there's gonna be a cutscene, so let's get right to it.
There it is, the source of fire. This should do.
There's no one around. Isn't this the Inferno King's palace?
He is tending his wounds. The Inferno King and his assistants slumber in the molten lava as we speak. The Beldereaver has wounded him deeply.
Oswald still lives?
What a coincidence. Tis Braum.
Who are you?
I am not surprised that you fail to recognize me. I am the king who commissioned your first cipher.
What?
That torch, is that the source of fire? Once again, you tamper with the jewels without my permission. My skull may be filled with maggots, but I can still remember. You told the dwarves the secrets of how to process the jewels.
Queen, please follow me, and run!
Who was that?
I know not why he is here, but that was the ghost of King Valentine, ruler of the land I once called home. He has clearly lost his mind.
How can you be so rude to your former master? I deeply regret having kept you alive.
Clear the way, King Valentine.
That rock created from my furnace does not frighten me at all. Brom, is this jeweled artifact one of yours? Very well. Allow me to present my final creation to you.
A baby dragon.
A dragon with a crown.
You should know very well the powers in this crown. This hatchling has my power and consumed the fire's source.
What?
Now, my little spawn, devour these mortals before Onyx's forces arrive.
And once again, we're fighting Leventhan, the last dragon. I mean, it's kind of to be expected, but using Mercedes against him is probably going to be a lot easier than using most of the other characters. Simply because, you know, because of the fact that he flies, it's a lot easier to just kind of reload, hit him a thousand times, and just break that stupid shield he's got. There we go. I don't understand how it expects me to break his shield when I can't. Oh, well. When I can't attack, do the guard crush in the air. I assume it just expects me to hit him enough to break it. But either way, it just doesn't feel right. But Leventhan is pretty strong, so I gotta be a little bit more careful. Especially because he's got full screen attacks, so if I stop paying attention, oh god. If I stop paying attention, I'm incredibly screwed. Oh, big salamanders for no reason. Luckily, like I said, because I have that increased healing factor, this is actually quite a bit simpler. But just because it's a bit simpler doesn't mean I can take it easy. Leventhan feels easier than I was expecting, to be perfectly honest. But he ate the fire source. I don't know what that means in the context of the story. I mean, if it's the origination of fire and, you know, dragons breathe fire the way that they're supposed to like this, I guess that kind of means he's gotten more powerful. I don't know what he's expecting out of it. There we go. I wonder, does that mean I can... Oh, no. That was worth the experiment, though. Unlimited ammo doesn't mean I have unlimited pal meter. It just means I have unlimited... shots until the effect is over. Okay, that's good to know. Because if it was like unlimited pal meter, I feel like that'd be borderline broken. Come on, get off. Oh, he's reached super mode once again. So we gotta be a little bit more careful. Usually happens after the second half of the fight. So I kind of expected it, but I wasn't expecting it so soon. Still unlimited ammo. And then let's do Banshee's Call. And let's do Pixie's Call. Just going all in. Come on, don't make me waste my time. Leventhan. Man, this combo right here is so good. I freaking love it. It's just, it feels so satisfying. I can't describe how great it feels to have like everything going all together all at once. I wonder how you trained this dragon. Like, that's my big question. Is he listening to him just because he's using the source of his power, which is the magic? Also, God, Leventhan looks so cute as a baby dragon.
Upon returning from the Fire Kingdom, Brahm locked himself away in the royal armory.
How may I serve?
Gather some willing troops. There is little time to launch a counterattack. Matthew, allow the Lilliputs into the forge and let them work on weapons and armor. Tell them to do their best and match the skills of the Demon Lord's dwarves.
Understood.
I am going to speak to the Paladins and inform their leader of what to expect.
Your Majesty.
There you are, Brahm. Is it complete?
'Tis my life's masterpiece. And with this, I shut the curtains on my career as a blacksmith.
Brahm.
I have a request. May I have some time off? It pains me to not be able to see my work in action. But I have learned that Oswald, the wielder of the Beldarrhoeder, is still alive. It is my fault that his life is in shambles. He may not wish to see me, but I want to go to him.
I see. Do what you must. Don't worry about the weapon. I shall make news of my victory ring loud and clear across the land.
These rickety bones make it difficult to compete against others in battle. Now, please take this. This lethal bow. I have stripped it of its former name, the Tasla, and renamed it Ribla. It means the piercing one in the old dwarf tongue. 'Tis the only cipher in all the world with the power to destroy another.
And with that, we gain Lunar Side Shot, our ultimate ability. I was going to save up a bunch of cipher points for upgrading it all the way, but I don't think I actually have enough. Well, maybe I do. It costs 50, maybe it costs 150 or less. 125, yeah, I do have enough. Sweet, perfect, awesome. Yep, and now, does it actually change name, or is that just, it's always going to be called the Cipher? I was curious to see if it actually changed its name, but whatever. Let's see, we gained one level, it's not enough to get anything else. I do want to get resistance, so I'll probably level up to 50 between episodes. Oh, we earned a trophy as well, and, you know, I guess I'll just see you guys in the next one, so... See you later, everybody.